Hi, I'm Krista Clapp. I'm a research director for climate finance at Cicero, and I'm leading the ClimInvest project. ClimInvest aims to improve our understanding of physical climate risk and brings together climate scientists and investors. We're trying to understand how investors can better secure the value of their portfolios against physical climate risk, to understand which physical risks are of require immediate attention, and to understand what information and data investors can use. The International Research Consortium consists of Cicero in Norway, Varnagen Environmental Research and Climate Adaptation Services in the Netherlands, I4CE, Meteo France, and Carbon4 in France. It is a JPI climate project funded by the European Research Area for Climate Services. We put together this series of webinars to take a deeper dive into some of the physical hazards and to explore some case studies. Today's presentation will dig into the drought hazard and is presented by Anne-Sophie Dalloz.
Hello, I'm Anne-Sophie Dalloz. I'm a climate scientist at Cicero. And today I will talk about the climate risk and how this climate risk matters for financial decision makers. And more specifically, I will talk about the climate risk related to drought. The first part of the presentation will talk about the climate risk and how we define it. And then in the second part, once we know more about the climate risk related to drought, we will think about how actually it's relevant for investors and their assets. And once we know more about the relevance for investors, we can think about how we can prepare and think about the adaptative capacity. So first, a few key considerations about drought. So drought is not limited to a lack of rain. It's of course related to a lack of rain, but it's also important to think that drought is regionally specific. Depending on the region you look at, you might think about drought or define drought differently. And drought and its stress do not always occur together. They can occur together, but they are not systematically occurring at the same time. And when you have an extended time with drought, that can have huge impact on land and on the soil, and that can lead to exacerbate flooding conditions. So now, how do we generally define the climate risk? Not only for drought, but also for drought, but for heat wave and flooding. So we can use the definition of the IPCC framework, which says that the climate risk is a combination of the climate hazard, the exposure to the climate hazard, in our case, the exposure to drought, and the vulnerability. And in our case, as we are looking at the financial sector, we can define vulnerability as a combination of the sector sensitivity and its adaptative capacity. So first, let's think about the exposure to drought. So there are different ways to define the exposure to drought. It will depend on a large number of things, including maybe the sector you're looking at. But one definition can be the length of drought even. And the definition in this case would be the maximum number of consecutive days when daily precipitation is under 1 millimeter per day. So you can look at the exposure, for example, in Europe with this map for the year 2020. And you will see with the warm colors in the southern part of Europe that the southern part of Europe is more exposed to drought, which is expected. But what is more important and more interesting maybe is to look at how we will evolve in the future. It's not necessarily surprising either, but you can see that the southern part of Europe with the warm colors of the map will be more exposed to drought in the future. And that's something we need to think about. Another thing to take into account, as we have said before, is the vulnerability of the asset. So, for example, you can think like depending on the construction materials and design of the asset, you will be more or less vulnerable. The age of the asset, the connectivity of the asset, the time horizon of the asset, all these things will be important for the vulnerability of the asset. So as you can see, with this combination of things, the climate risk, I think, is important for the financial sector. And we can take an example here to show how it's relevant, for example, for the agricultural sector. So if you have an increase in drought, you can imagine that then the crop yields can be reduced due to a dry soil, and that will decrease your revenue. Also, if you have more droughts, you might tend to use more irrigation, and that will increase the operation cost. And that also is an financial impact for agriculture or for your asset. So now we can see how the climate risk is relevant for investors, for example, in the agricultural sector. And now that we know more about the risk for agriculture, for example, we can think how we can adapt. So, for example, you could use irrigation, install drip irrigation to use less water. You could also shift your crops to varieties that are more resistant to drought. And you could also think about using early warning systems. So there are a number of things that you can do for adapting to the climate risk, but you need to consider it first. So in summary, I think it's important to remember that drought is a risk for investors in Europe. And the risk is not only defined in relation to hazard and exposure, you also need to think about vulnerability. And once you know about the climate risk, you will be able to think about your adaptive capacity.